Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming, and welcome back to Transport Fever Hard Mode Truck Fever Edition. For those who don't know what this series is about, we are going for several hard mode achievements, as well as the Truck Fever achievement. The goal to get $50 million with no trains, as well as Transport Shark, $100 million in hard mode, Transport Tycoon, $1 billion in hard mode, Penny Pincher in hard mode, no additional loans. So yeah, that is what it's all about. So we have $204K in the bank. We have spent a total of $1 million overall. And yeah, we made a fair bit of income here. And it is May, so we're on a good track to get going. We have, we're just gonna let things tick. This will be a very slow game until we get things ramped up to the point where, of course, we can start spending crazy amounts of money. When we take a look at our loan, we're paying $30,000 interest on $1.2 million of loans. I don't know exactly how much that is. It's like, how does that divide into? It's $10K per $400,000, I think. All right about that. So, just speed things up. We have quite a lot of stuff sitting here. 56 units. Let's buy a couple more horse wagons, because we'll make our money back pretty quickly. units sitting here. $1.73, $2.60. I must have had some trucks that weren't pulling full loads. All right. With this, we're up to $217K in the bank. Let's buy a few more trucks. Salinas food. And I am considering running a Buffalo to Tampa line. How are we doing for? Nope, not you. 47 of 55, 80% supply. Although with that said, the amount of time it will take vehicles to get back and drop off is right now 27 second frequency. That means a truck should pull up every, 14 days-ish? So yeah, about that. We might be at a point where we're oversupplying the town. So we are going to want to be concerned about that. Down to 47 of 55. 346. This is not going up. We should be covering the entire thing. The entire town, yep. Okay. Oh, there we go. 51 of 55. Unless it updates at the end of the month. Anyway, we can take a look at this. Supply rating 58%. Okay. They're all 58%. All being equally supplied. We have 209 in the bank. what we could do is start setting up another route, although we are not going to be able to dedicate as many trucks to the line as we did with the Salinas food line. Now we are going to build a truck station very expensively. And apparently, wow. Build that there. Is that covered? There to there, and then into here. Covers most of the industry. So what we are going to do, put another depot. And we're going to build it right about here. By road vehicles. One for now. New line. We are going to go from here all the way to here, all the way to here. The reason I'm not dropping it off in Tampa, I think that's Tampa, yep, is because I want them to drive as far as possible full. So they'll go from here, over to there, over to here with goods, and then they'll come back here empty. If I went from here, over to here, back to here, this part of the journey would be empty. It wouldn't be making me money. Where on the other hand, here to here to here is all full, making pure profit. And then this is just the trip or part of the trip that is, yep, full. Anyway, or rather empty. This is going to be RF Buffalo Oil. And we are going to let that tick. And what I would like you to do is load if available, or rather full load. We're going to set this to unlimited. And you're just going to sit here and wait. Sit and wait and like it. So we'll put that there. We are going to put that over there. And yeah, over there. And we already have 8 units. Nice. Buy road vehicles. We're going to buy 2 more. And we're going to set this to Buffalo Oil. And yeah, perfect. They go directly into here like they're supposed to. We're going to say load if available. We're going to buy another horse wagon. Same thing, Buffalo Oil. And another one, Buffalo Oil. And we'll buy another one, Buffalo Oil. And we will buy another one, Buffalo Oil. And yet, line you suggests. Production's up to 60. Over here, how are we doing at the farm? The farm is 150 production. Wow. It's bumped up right away to a limit of 400. Nice. Got a ton of grain sitting there. And we have a production of 82 with a limit of 200. So yeah, I bet that. Although with that said, how are we doing for 95%? Yeah, the demand has been reduced because we're oversupplying the town. It has still has potential 74. Really? It's at least a year's supply. And this is showing a potential of 169 for livestock. And now we have 147 in the bank. We're going to buy up. Nope, not them. And I, yeah, paid some running costs on those. Buffalo oil. And where's our trucks? This one. Yeah, I bet that they haven't even made their drop off. I'd like to know how much they'll be getting paid for that trip. And we are gonna buy a couple more Buffalo oil. And you're making 613. Nice. Let's buy two more. Put on Buffalo oil. Yeah, one more Buffalo oil. So if this to this distance is 613, I am going to suspect that we're going to get at least $8 from a fuel delivery to Buffalo. So that's pretty decent. We could have set this one up, although I would have probably wanted to have built a road, which wouldn't have been a good thing. And yep, 613. This is just all going to start accumulating, making us some pretty decent money. We already have a positive balance of 16 on that, 117 on this line. Nice. Finances. Yeah, we already have paid for this year's and last year's running costs. We got 35 units sitting here, so we are going to just keep buying some horse wagons, Buffalo oil. And you, did you go full? Yep. Let's buy a couple more Buffalo oil. And basically, once these trucks get rolling, they'll be just making, churning out the money. And we are going to buy another one and Buffalo oil. It'll take a little while for this line to make money. $56 of $58. Yeah, I bet that. One thing we are going to want to consider, of course, is to run a freight line between Buffalo and Salinas. Although at this point in time, we are nowhere near getting that set up. We are, of course, going to need fuel to start flowing in. And right now, we don't got any fuel. Wow. Oh, that's right. With the refinery, what ends up happening is that with the first units of crude oil, it starts producing and fills up its internal storage of oil, meaning a whole bunch of your trucks come back empty. That's one of the quirks of the oil refinery, unfortunately. So yeah, we're losing a little bit of money there. And that truck is the first one to have fuel, so we're going to put it there, And we are just going to... Do we run... What I am going to want to do as well. No, we're going to want to wait till we make some money back. But we are going to put a few more on the line. And where are you right now? You are right here. All right, bet this. Right now we have, how many trucks do we have on the line? Not vehicles, we want lines. 41 trucks on the Salinas line, 27 trucks on the Buffalo line. We are hauling 29 of 40, 33 of 40 units of fuel, 24 of 68 units of crude oil, 64, 60 of 60 of livestock, 8 of 8, 31 of 96 food. We're starting to make a little bit more money. It is 1857. We're not yet at the point of massive significant profits, but that is just to be expected. I'm expecting possibly 1880, maybe 1890 is when I will be able to become debt free. Although with that said, I will be holding off paying off any debt until I don't actually need the money. Of course, since we are not going trains, we will not need any massive outlays of cash because rail is expensive. And the general is available. Like if we were to run rail from here, over here, $20 million. Although that said, yeah. About that. Rail is expensive, trains are expensive, trucks are cheap, they are profitable, extremely profitable, which is why you should always try to run them. And our first load of fuel is coming into the town of Buffalo. And how much are you going to be making me? I'm expecting probably around 10.5K. Nice. So that's about 16 point something per unit, or not per unit, per four units round trip. Nice. And yeah, now we're just going to start making money. That one's apparently only 5.23. You have only two on you. You don't have any on you. Alright, about that. We're going to buy some more road vehicles. And Buffalo oil. How are we doing here in Salinas? We're 100% supplied. We are making a total of 302K. At least we made 302K last year. It is August, 168K this year. We have a running cost of 166K, so we're at about a 2-to-1 ratio, roughly. Although with that said, we have vehicles, running cost. Yeah, $9.31 for property maintenance, income, and loan interest. As I figured this would be a very slow one to get started, but once, of course, the cargo ramps up, it'll be a whole lot better. Be having so much cash in the bank that a Buffalo to Salinas tunnel will not be that much of an issue. Yep, about that. 3 million for that. Yeah, 54.1k at the moment. What I would like to do though is, all right, so we got residential here. I'm going to probably want to have a truck station here. It's a little bit of a slope. Or not a truck station. We're going to go with a bus tram station. We're only going to need this small one. Put it right there. We're going to build one over in Buffalo. Oh, seriously? Yeah, about that. You know what? I'd love to put it here. Actually, traffic can be coming in from here. And we're going to go with a large one. I'm actually going to put it right here, I think. And we are going to go with a medium straight, I think. Like that. We're gonna bring this across. And now we are gonna set up some bus stops. Because reasons. Alright, so people are wanna go to jobs as well as the bus tram station. We are going to want to have a stop here. We're going to put a stop there. I'm going to do a stop to here. Stop here. And I might just there, there, and we'll put there and there for future expansion. We are going to set up an internal line. Just going to have this bus Buffalo RT1, and we are going to go from over to there, there. Back to here, and we'll just have a loop going back the other way. Alright, that. So that is 22 stops. We're gonna do the same thing here in Salinas. Now, where do we want to have our bus terminal? I'm thinking probably, oh no, we already have one. That's right. Alright, so how are we going to have our, we are going to one right here. We're gonna actually right there. Put that there. Right there. And then we will put there. And then we will do a drop off there. We're up to 144K in the bank. And we are going to go at station. There to there, there to there, back to there. Or coming back around. And now we are going to name this bus. Where is this? Salinas RT1. We're going to color it red. And we are going to rename this Salinas Central. And over here, we're going to call this Buffalo Central. 163 in the bank. How are we doing income wise? Well, up to 376,000 income in 1859, down to 367 in 1860. It is March. We're up to 66,000 in income. If we take a look at the various lines, we have 103K profit from Salinas Food, 27 second frequency, and 109 from Buffalo Oil. Now, what we're also going to do, we are going to set up a new line from here over to here. We're going to call this 1-F Salinas to Buffalo. We're also going to set up a new line from here over to here. This is going to be 1-P Salinas to Buffalo. 257K in the bank. We are going to Let's go Pro Depot. We'll put it out here. We're going to buy a horse carriage. We're going to set this to the 1P line and a horse wagon to the 1F line. We're going to have these full load any and full load any. And this one is going to Salinas Central, and this one is going to that's Central. Call that Salinas Freight. All right, perfect. And full load any. Now, what that will do, of course, is it'll ramp up the demand and the potential for food. And it'll, of course, start splitting off the goods. We are, of course, going to want to buy road vehicles. We'll put two on the bus Salinas RT1. Over here, we are going to throw that there, and we are going to buy two horse carriages and Buffalo RT1. And for the Buffalo RT1 line, we are going to have it. Oh no, we just want load if available. It is the, actually we will full load any. And we will buy horse carriage, and we will set this to the 1P line, and a horse wagon over to the 1F line. Now, what that should do, of course, is generate some interest in traveling. Hopefully. If we look at our, 23 and 26 second frequencies. That might be a little bit high for there to there. Any way I can cut the distance? Not really. And another thing I'm going to want to do is for these, we're going to go unlimited and unlimited. Because I know what's going to happen. Yep. You're on the road. You're not carrying anyone. Go back. Same thing with you. Go back. I'd rather you sit and wait. Oh, look at that. We got some food heading over to Buffalo. And how about over here in, we don't got any fuel coming in. One thing we can of course do is buy some more horse wagons and set it to RF Buffalo Oil. Since we are going to start supplying Buffalo as well as Salinas, we might as well ramp up the number of trucks on each lines, because we're going to need more quantity. We'll buy three for the food line. Salinas food. But at this point in time, I might just take a break here. And we will, of course, come back with more hard mode truck fever in the next episode. Yeah, we got lots of stuff waiting here. Lots of stuff waiting there. It's just a matter of getting enough trucks on the line. We got fuel waiting there. We got food waiting there, I think. And it looks like our first load of food is head out. Nice. How about no fuel yet? Any fuel? How about Buffalo? You're 30 of 48. Yeah, about that. But we're making quite a bit of money. Yeah, 300,000-ish. Profit is kind of, we're treading water. But we need to spend money to make money. That's all that really matters. Anyway, at this point in time, I'm going to take a break here. And we will continue off with more Transport Fever, Truck Fever edition in the next episode. Thank you for joining me for this episode of Transport Fever. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott from SB Gaming. And as always, have a good day.